Hello, seniors. It's good to be able to talk to you again. I wish I could say it's good to see you again, but I can't see you. So I'm going to have to do this video once again and hopefully give you some encouragement. I'd like to make one announcement before I share a few words, and that is I would like to do a question and answer video. If you have any questions that you would like to ask, please send them my way at ddainsburg@aac.church. The third Sunday of each month, we usually have a Q&A in the choir room at 9:30 on Sunday mornings, and I'd like to do something similar to that through this video. You may have a lot of questions that have arisen over these past weeks in light of what is happening in our country and world. Please send them my way. I'll be happy to try and give an answer. I don't claim to have the answers to everything, but I can take you to God's Word, and God's Word can give us some insight and perspective on your journey. We are in the Easter season, and this is a monumental time of year as we celebrate the death and resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Our faith is based on these historical events. I'd like to share a quote with you that combines both the death and the resurrection. John Stott put it this way. He said, "The cross was the victory won, and the resurrection the victory endorsed, proclaimed, and demonstrated. Jesus Christ lives. By God's Spirit, we have life beyond the grave, and we have joy beyond belief." Christopher M. Idle, a contemporary British hymn writer, put it well in summarizing 1 Corinthians 15, which is known as the resurrection chapter. One of the verses in his song goes, "If Christ had not been raised from death, our faith would be in vain, our preaching but a waste of breath, our sin and guilt remain. But now the Lord is risen indeed. He rules in earth and heaven. His gospel meets a world in need. In Christ we are forgiven." Friends, though we're not together this Easter season, we won't be together at a Monday, Thursday service or a Good Friday or at Easter, I encourage you, as you are able to do in a safe way, to celebrate it with friends, with family, and worship with us online. I'd like to leave you with this benediction of hope from 1 Peter 1:3. "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Amen." All God's best to you. Remember that he is risen, and because of that fact, we are indeed blessed. Thank you, and happy Easter.